Wolves of Croton. The Untold Story of Milo. John Abdo. Prologue. What does it mean when a man's name is remembered thousands of years after his death? By the completion of this story, perhaps long before, you will learn many answers to that question. In stadiums routinely packed with tens of thousands, the Crotonian wrestler would enter the arena, then walk the entire oval, amazingly carrying a full-grown bull on his back. As he paced the track, the imposingly muscular strongman welcomed his cheering fans to slap the loins and tug the tail of his colossal bovine pet. Esteemed for his unfathomable prowess, he was called by the ancients Milo. Born in Croton, Italy, in 559 BC, he had been predicted by prognosticators to arrive as the mortal son of Zeus, with a direct lineage to the mighty Hercules. Through progressive adaptations and adherence to various unorthodox conditioning methodologies, Milo of Croton became the most dominant Olympian wrestler of all time, one who went on to crown a martial career as a revered military commander. Before you are escorted into the amphitheater of Milo's life, unveiled in Volume 1, Books 1-5, we will first establish a chronological framework elucidating the ideological infrastructure and mythological beliefs the ancients lived by and committed their hearts to. This journey will exhibit the geographical topographies and time periods in which Milo, and his genealogical influencers, walked the earth, while revealing psychophysiological lineages to such mythological deities as Cronos, Zeus, Mars, and Apollo, the demigods Romulus and Remus, and the mighty Hercules. In Volume 2, Book 620, commencing with Milo's birth, a chronological depiction of his formative years will be revealed. You will observe the Crotonian transcending various stages in his maturation from a child into a teen, then into an adult, and learn about his unusual relationships with the mongoose, a dominant pack of wolves, and his celebrated pet bull. You will also attend many of Milo's pioneering strength conditioning sessions and wrestling practices, and, to counterbalance allegations regarding his all-brawn persona, meet his mentor, the master of wisdom, Pythagoras. Furthermore, in the following pages, you will meet Milo's teammates, friends, and foes. Take a seat inside the Olympiad arena where he accomplished his most illustrious wrestling achievements, and then march onto a battlefield where an aged Milo commanded a numerically inferior army to fight Croton's archenemy in a great battle that historians have revisited for eons. We begin this story on a terrifying day, 26 years before the birth of Milo.
I'm John Abdo. I want to thank you for listening. Here's a link on how you can get a copy of my book, Wolves of Croton, The Untold Story of Milo.